Hi everyone, Stephen Lee here. It is tax season, and in this video, I'm gonna be covering how the CARES Act, which was recently passed late last year, is gonna affect your 2020 income tax return. I'm gonna be covering the following five issues. Number one is new rules for charitable contributions, and a new $300 tax deduction you may be eligible for. Number two is early retirement account withdrawals. I've been getting a lot of questions on this. Number three is stimulus payments received and if they are taxable. So are your stimulus payments that you received in 2020 taxable or 2021? Number four is, are unemployment benefits taxable? I've been getting a lot of questions on this as well. And number five is, can you take the home office deduction if you worked remotely in 2020? This is a very common question, and I'm going to cover that in this video. So let's get right into topic number one, charitable contributions made in 2020. In the past, only those who itemized their deductions were able to get a tax benefit from any charitable contributions made. But under the CARES Act, taxpayers who do not itemize can deduct up to $300 in cash contributions made during the 2020 year. So remember, in the past, only those who took the itemized deduction, not the standard deduction, were able to benefit from any charitable contributions made. But this year, under the CARES Act for 2020, you're allowed a $300 deduction if you made $300 worth of cash contributions during the 2020 year. So look out for that. Even if you do take the standard deduction, you are eligible for that $300 deduction if you made up to $300 worth of cash contributions to charitable organizations. But for 2020, those who do itemize their deductions, you can deduct charitable donations up to 100% of your 2020 adjusted gross income. In the past, there was a cap based on your adjusted gross income, but for 2020 alone, under the CARES Act, you're allowed to deduct 100% of your charitable contributions up to 100% of your 2020 adjusted gross income. So this is a big change. So if you take the standard deduction, make sure you list any cash contributions you've made. If you're itemizing, make sure to include those as well. Number two is early withdrawals of retirement contributions. Okay, many of you took out COVID-related early withdrawal distributions from your retirement accounts. I'm gonna cover that right now. In the past, if you withdrew or took a distribution from an IRA or a 401k prematurely means before you hit age 59 and a half, you incurred a 10% penalty on that withdrawal. But under the CARES Act, taxpayers who took a COVID-related distribution in 2020 from a retirement account up to $100,000 are not subject to the 10% penalty. Remember, it's cumulative up to $100,000, not per account, but cumulatively. If you take in a COVID-related distribution, an early distribution, you are not going to be subject to the 10% penalty. And I'll leave a link to my video where I cover all about this, the more details in terms of do you have a COVID-related distribution. Okay. In addition, you have the option to report the income over 3 years rather than all in 2020. Just remember, if you use the three-year method, you have to report them in three equal parts. Okay. So for example, let's say you took out a $75,000 COVID-related distribution, okay, in 2020, then you have to report, and you elect to do the three-year, then you have to report $25,000 in 2020, $25,000 in 2021, and $25,000 in 2022, so in equal parts, okay? Remember that you need to include the form 8915-E in order to have that 10% penalty waived from your 2020 return. Okay, so remember, it's the form 8915E. So as you're preparing your return, and if you see that 10% penalty pop up, that means you did not fill out the 8915E to get that 10% penalty waived. Okay, lastly, remember, if you repay the distribution that you took out in 2020, within 3 years, you won't owe any taxes. Okay, so the question comes out, okay, let's say I repay it back in 2021 or 2022, then how do I reclaim any taxes that I paid on that income, right, that I reported in 2020? You have to amend your return, okay? So let's say you repay back in 2022 the entire distribution you took out in 2020, then you have to probably amend your 2020 return and your 2021 return to reclaim any taxes that you paid on that income that you reported. Remember, if this is the kind of content that you're looking for, don't forget to subscribe and turn on your notifications. All right, topic number three, are stimulus payments taxable? Okay, the answer is no. Even if you do not qualify for a stimulus payment based on your 2020 income tax return, previously received stimulus payments are not taxable. Okay, if you had qualified for a stimulus payment, but you did not receive all of it or only a partial amount, you can claim the qualified payments via the recovery rebate credit. Okay, so this is something that you need to be aware of when you're filling out your 2020 return, the recovery rebate credit. I'll leave a link in the information section below in regards to how to fill out that recovery rebate worksheet to figure out what you put on that line to reclaim any qualified, unclaimed stimulus payments. Just remember that your qualification is only going to be based on your 2020 income tax return, not 19 or 18, but your 2020 return. Number four is, are unemployment benefits taxable? Okay, the answer is yes. If you received unemployment benefits from your state or any federal unemployment benefits, such benefits are taxable and should be reported on your 2020 income tax return. And I get this question a lot. Are unemployment benefits taxable? The answer, once again, is yes, they are. So look out for that 1099-G. It's the form that the government's going to send you to report that income. Number five is the home office deduction. Okay, the home office deduction. When many workplaces switched to remote work back in March of 2020, many people set up home offices so they can continue to do their jobs. Now the question is your home office deductible? The answer is it depends. If you're an employee, you know, and you have an employer, then the answer is no. You cannot deduct, unfortunately, any home office related expenses. Okay, so if you're an employee, once again, and if that means if you receive a W-2 at the end of the year, then you do not qualify for the home office deduction, unfortunately. If you're self-employed, however, that means sole proprietor, independent contractor, or a gig worker, and you report your income and expenses on a Schedule C, then yes, your home office, eligible home office expenses are deductible. Remember, there's two different methods. There's the standard method or the easy method, which is $5 per square foot, up to 300 square feet of a dedicated home office space. And then there's the regular method, which is basically you have to add up all your home related expenses, mortgage interest, utilities, things like that. And then you basically come up with a ratio of what portion is the home office compared to the entire home. So for example, let's say your home office is 100 square feet and your home entire home is 1,000 square feet. Then 10% of those eligible home office expenses, you know, utilities, mortgage interest, things like that, added together, only 10% of that will be deductible. All right, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and continue to leave any great questions or comments that you have. Until next time, I wish you a wonderful and safe day. Bye.